All right, so we're going to keep talking about Pratt Whitney. Suddenly, in the mid-1980s, Pratt faced competition from all of its major product categories, and its market share began to slip across the board. In addition, the total engine deliveries in the industry began to fall due to the shift from 4 to 2 engine designs. Pratt's management was not completely asleep, and 3 innovations, which seemed earth-shattering at the time, were introduced in response. 1 in production, and 2 to bridge the chasm between product development and production. The major innovation in the physical production system introduced in 1984 was a focus factory with flow lines and business units organized by category of parts. Pratt's factory structure, emerging from 3 hot wars, World War II, Korea, and Vietnam, and 1 Cold War, was a hodgepodge of isolated shops working on parts with no relation to the part being made in the next shop. In one notable case, the distance traveled by a part within Pratt's plants, not counting the distance traveled between the plants, was measured and found to be a total of 18 miles. In 1984, Pratt reorganized its facilities so each would take responsibility for a major category of engine parts. The massive North Haven plant would work primarily on turbine blades, which, while the Southington plant would work primarily on rotors and discs, and the Middleton plant would take on all the final assembly work. Within each plant, activities were further reorganized so that many of the steps in the physical process of each category of part were grouped and lined up in a logistical progression in the flow line, insofar as total designs were permit. Note that this is exactly the concept described in 1936 by Carlton Ward, the assistant general manager of production at Pratt. Finally, each part category, for example, high temperature turbine blades for the GT8D engine, was placed in a business unit whose leader knew the cost for his operation. The business unit head was fully in charge of getting the parts made at cost and on time in accordance with the master schedule. Now, run off massive computerized material requirement planning systems, okay? So kind of similar to what we were doing, we had everything just grouped by machine size. Now we've got stuff grouped by product groups in our value streams, right? There's a lot of Filtran and White so that they have all the same products. And then, you know, in Blue, we have a lot of different products, but we're grouping them together with LK going all in the same press and breaking down into smaller groups. So everybody kind of has the same thing. So that's kind of the value stream concept starting at Pratt Whitney here.